Discussion. People were just talking back and forth, and I caught some of it, but not all of it by any means. And there was no formal decisions made. We just agreed to meet again today.
So, my take from this, I wrote this in the report.
Yep.
My take from the discussion that we had with Paul and the participation officers is that we do not work with officers do.
specifically that the CPOs are not?
They mentioned it. They said.
Oh.
I believe it was Jen, it's in your minutes, said that their purview is for
town manager.
Town manager appointments only. They do not have any power.
They use the word only?
Yes.
I missed that.
Can I just see what was the general, this general envelope topic?
Is that
outreach?
Outreach communications, what's our role?
Outreach, what's your role?
Do you think that it would be helpful for us to set up regular meeting times, regular times for them to come to our?
We asked that, they said no, thank you.
No.
Didn't, well, Paul came to what, our last meeting, one meeting with us, with two of them.
Sort of, how do you get to know reading session, right?
Right.
But no agreement or no sense that out of every other week or every, I mean, it could be once a month.
So once a month.
We could ask them, we could ask them once a month.
We could ask again.
Yeah.
We asked that at our last subcommittee meeting and they said, no, we don't see that as part of their role, but I can ask if they can extend the invitation again.
You mean coming to being, if we invited them just to come and report on what they've been up to, they didn't feel like that was something that they wanted to do.
They could do, I mean, they don't really want to do regular. If there's something that we want to ask them in particular, absolutely.
Well, we just want to.
Once a month for a half an hour.
Touch base and see what they're up to, yeah. I mean, who else is overseeing what they're doing?
So they're seeing themselves as their authority is town.
Okay.
Well, I think that we need to be, you know, like encouraging us to all be more holistic, you know, to be working together with them cooperatively. And I have attended the last two meetings of the Resident Advisory Committee. And I think that's actually a fairly good idea. If they meet, it might be nice for one of us to go to their meetings if we could get ourselves invited. Just because it's just good to maintain a good relationship, you know? I think it was Jennifer came to my district meeting on Thursday.
Right.
And that added so much to it. You know, she really was able to answer a lot of the questions, and she was just a very good kind of bridge, I felt, at the meeting. And so I think we need to really try to.
So, would you, as an action item, do you want to have one of us suggest what they ask if we can have our members regularly go to their meetings? And then do you want to suggest a schedule in which they can come and just check in us? So, what would you want to do?
Yeah, like maybe, you know, our first meeting of the month or something, or whatever, to make it easy so they know when it is to come and come to this little meeting.
And they're coming here to just tell us what they've been up to for the last month.
Yeah, and figure out ways that we can work together, you know, how we can help them, how they can help us.
And Sarah's expressed some reservation, or at least a thought, that there might be a tension between them reporting to the town manager, who is their boss, and them reporting to us. And they might feel uneasy as to, you know, we're not giving them marching orders, we're not telling them what to do, we're not their boss, we don't oversee them,
right.
That's correct, but we are sort of, we'd like to know what success they've had and what outreach they've been doing, and as a courtesy to us, we would appreciate that once a month, is what we're basically asking for them.
Yeah.
And if they have an objection to that, I guess they'll tell us, but the hope is they wouldn't, but so we'd ask them like once a month just to check in with us as a courtesy.
And I guess if we have a liaison, we'll use that for one of us.
And their meetings being the RAC?
No, the Community Participation Officers.
Oh, Lordy. They have meetings too?
Yeah.
Count me out on that one. Okay. I mean, I'm happy to have them report
well,
to me, but
been,
I'm deciding.
They haven't invited us to their meeting,
yeah.
But I have gone. The RAC meetings are posted.
Yes, that's right.
Posted
exactly.
Meetings.
I think we don't need to attend CPO meetings.
So
I think
so
not. It's just the RAC.
All right, so
and I, you know.
The RAC. So it's the RAC that you want me to reach out to?
Yes.
RACC.
Resident Advisory Council. Which is appointed by Paul, and they work closely. He works with them individually, really more than as a committee, I think, is what his sense was. I got from listening to him.
Yeah, he doesn't feel like they have anything to do with us.
Yeah.
But if you want to just state that again, I'll reach out to them and then make sure that that's how they feel. But that's my understanding, that the Resident Advisory Committee does not have anything to do with us. But I will try to make that a fact, if it is or it isn't.
Well, you know, it seems like we should be working toward, you know, working more in collaboration and cooperation with the town manager.
I agree.
Yeah, I would like to have connections with both of those bodies, and I think that that it can only help. I think that, you know, we just have to have more communication, I think.
So, I agree. What I would propose that to Paul and about President Budget Committee and to CPOs at the last meeting, and it's my
right.
Plan, they said no, thank you. I will ask again.
Mm.
And if there's something
and again, you're asking, I just want to be clear on what you're going to be asking,
so,
Paul.
This is what I had, is that could one of us go to their meetings? Now, I'm assuming that's only the Resident Advisory Committee? Because we don't know if the CPOs have meetings.
I'm uncomfortable with that. I understand the town manager's concern. It's really, there's the separation here. So you may go ahead and do this if you wish, but I'm uncomfortable with asking him if one of us, whoever that may be, can be present at an RAC meeting. Though apparently it's a public meeting, right?
Yeah,
so that's a non-issue. We can be there if we want to be. And if people want to go, they can go. The CPOs they do meet, apparently. But you know what? That's a meeting between them and Paul, I guess. It's a staff meeting, right? It's not
yeah,
a public meeting. So I think we should, you know, I don't see any reason for us to be present at those meetings. We just like to know what they're doing.
So CPOs have to write regular reports.
Oh, okay.
Will be sent to us.
All right. That may be sufficient.
We could just ask if there's some way that they could check in with us.
Well, maybe the reports will do. I mean, they have a lot on their plate, and they're taking this on in addition to their regular duties. So this is it, and they seem to be eager about it and so forth. So maybe reports will be sufficient for the time being. If we feel, I guess, over time that we're really not getting much and we're not getting reports aren't very helpful, then I guess we could say, could you please come and see us? But maybe we should allow them some space. You know, they seem to be doing good work. They seem to be excited about it. Maybe we just lay low for a bit and see what's going on. Not even ask them to say, well, we want you to come once a month. As long as reports, if we're getting reports from them, let's let it go for a couple months and see how it goes. And then if we feel that we're not getting enough information and we feel like we're out of the loop and we don't know what's going on and we're in the dark, then I guess we could ask them to come and see us. But I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like they've already told us.
They've already told you, right. So why are we going back again? Right. Yeah, and I don't see the reason to push at the moment.
So I guess the bigger question for me then is, what is OPA's role
in
outreach and communication?
Right.
At this point, the only thing I can think of is one, helping people plan for and to recruit people to come to residents to come to public hearings and forums. That's something that's been brought up by the president to myself, the finance committee has posed. Now, when I asked Paul about this, he said trying to get residents to come to these should not be our job, but it should be the job of staff.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what I'm going to bring up to you about this, is that, so when you think about planning a forum or you think about planning special meetings like hearings, like finance committee is doing, right? And we have two, at least a minimum of two public forums that we have to hold,
school committee?
I think it's the capital plan.
Yeah, it's the capital plan, yep. So, what I did was, I don't know if you guys have this, or I don't think I put it in.
Right, yeah.
Right, I have them, yeah.
As to how to plan for a district meeting or office hours, and as I go through this, I feel like this sort of covers, so one is, call 413-259-3002, or email, voicedinj@amherstmass.gov. And the town manager at amherstmass.gov to secure a meeting space. So that seems like a logical for, my case being that I think that this is not setting up a public hearing or advertising for a public hearing or a forum could be done in a similar way. I don't know that I would change. This is what I'm proposing to you. So that you would follow the guidelines for district meeting or office hours for a hearing or a forum. And the only things that I changed was, we're not sharing
so
it.
So who you're suggesting that for?
So here's my question. So one of the things that people are saying could be our role is if somebody wants to have a forum or they want to have a hearing, right? So say finance committee, one of the two forums that town council itself has to hold, right? The president is in charge of that, of those.
Right.
Then they need to do all the same things we would need to do if we were doing a district meeting. You have to get a room, you have to find a room, right?
And that isn't something that staff is already doing?
Well, that's what I'm saying, is that if you look at that list right there, what I'm posing to you is that the guidelines for that, except for a few things that I changed, could also be the guidelines for, I'm going to come down.
For us, for setting up a hearing.
Yeah, it doesn't need to be us. What I think is that this could be, as Paul said, this could be his staff, which also means community participation officers would be doing this, because it seems like it makes more sense to me, because except for on there, I believe I added, when you're trying to reserve a room, you could ask for if you need microphones, and the right? Is it set up in a room, you could ask for microphones, you could ask for PowerPoint, right?
So isn't something that they would just normally do anyway?
Right.
It hasn't been publicly stated that they do this. There is
that the CPOs do it?
Right. I wanted to send an email with just a few changes to say to the CPOs and town manager, it seems to me, and we're talking with Paul, who said that he felt that this should be also under the purview of the CPOs. Not making sense.
Well, it's not clear what this is now.
Okay, so
you're talking about
setting up. So there's two things. One
right.
is setting up and organizing a
right.
public hearing.
Well, we've never right. Yeah.
Or a forum.
Well, never had a public hearing yet, correct? We've never had a public hearing. And those are set by the council, right? The council is, the council and the president, I assume, does this.
Yes, that's what's in the charter.
Right.
It's
so,
been suggested to me by
right.
finance committee and also by Lynn
yep.
that they believe that it is OPA's responsibility to advertise for these special type meetings. And it's up to us to get residents to come in.
Okay.
What Paul said is he does not feel that that's up to us, that actually all of the things that the community participation officers do to advertise for and bring people in for things like district meetings should be sufficient and the same.
Right.
Which
right.
is posting it on the website, right?
Right.
All of those things, whether
right.
posting the meeting, posting it on the website,
right.
You could post it on individual counselors. Some of the suggestions were that we could ask for an outside bulletin board on which we would post posters, or that we could have each counselor would find people in their district, or we would, to find people to put up posters in different districts. I don't necessarily know that I see myself running around.
Yeah, I think this is getting down to the level of staff and sort of, I thought our job was really oversight, just trying to make sure that that first of all, nobody knows who's had a district meeting yet or not. I mean, as a group. So it'd be nice if the council actually knew.
We do have a council calendar now.
Right. So I guess you go to council calendar and you
right,
can look at it. But it might be useful to just have a report at some point or some kind of at every council meeting said, here's what's been happening on the outreach front. You know, there's been these district meetings and da-da-da-da-da. But maybe you're thinking, oh, as long as it's available on the calendar, people can go and find out what's going on. So we don't need to do sort of oversight in that sense. That's taken care of by the calendar. Do we need to coordinate? Do we need to make sure that these meetings are not all happening on the same weekend or the same month or whatever? Do we need to worry about that? Who oversees the sort of overall coordination of district meetings? So, and they're sensitive to, would they raise a flag if they felt like, you know, A, somebody's not having them, or B, they're all turning out to be on the same month or all on the same weekend?
There is
that something we should even worry about?
Well, so here's the thing. So if you want to post an event, right, that you're doing,
yeah.
I believe right now it goes through, you have to submit an agenda and you have to submit, let's see if I can find it.
Right.
Goes through Jennifer.
Right, goes through Jennifer.
So all those things go
right.
through her, and
right.
there is a council calendar with which we can communicate with each other, right? So, George, you're saying, I'm going to have one this Sunday. I'm going to have a
mm-hmm.
district meeting this Sunday. When I go, because I also thought this would be a great weekend for me to have one,
right.
I don't see that you are also
right.
holding one.
Right, calendar might prevent
that. And I
that,
believe
right.
that what is expected is that counselors have enough common sense to not, you know, put all of our meetings on the same day.
Well, I just think counselors have so much they're doing that, yeah, but you're right. I mean, just pay attention.
I
didn't
bring that up. I mean, that is one of the things is that, you know, how to help counselors communicate with each other better. If there is something that you feel like counselors should be doing in addition to posting things on the calendar, then we could bring up the fact that we think that counselors would report together from certain districts, what they did either for office hours or for district meetings, and you could even say they should report out on what they're planning on doing in the next 3 months, 2 months, if applicable. Do you think that that's an extra step?
I think that's a good idea. Actually, it probably would be good also to have like an agenda item at one meeting where we just have, you know, a half an hour or two for each counselor to say, this is how my district meetings have been going, and these are the things that have worked, these are the things that haven't worked. Because I don't know how else we can have that discussion, because we can't just
Well, we have a place
right
for
now.
Counselor comments at the end of the meeting, so in theory one could always use that as a way of doing that. But
we
you're thinking making it a permanent or
we
sort of
ask.
Like, our meetings are long enough.
I know,
yes.
Nobody wants to hear it when we get to that
No, by that point,
meeting.
Nobody wants to hear it.
No.
But
I think that, you know, maybe 10 minutes for each.
Even 10 minutes. Even 10 minutes is 130 minutes.
Counselor, you can switch off, however, counselor in the district.
You don't want to hear about the district meetings, George?
Well, I'm just saying, George
yeah.
was wondering about, and this is something that's come up, like
our meetings are
5.5 hours.
Us
to communicate with each other. So if you think that would be something that would be helpful, that is something that we could ask about. If you think that the calendar probably isn't enough, but we need to sort of be...
I'm just trying to get a sense, as you are, and I think all of us are, trying, what is our job? And I don't want us to be involved in, you know, putting up posters and,
yeah.
and you know... that kind of stuff.
You don't want to scout your district for
well,
trash?
That's what I do in my district, but it's not the job of this committee to do the job for the council. I mean, I don't have office hours, for instance, and I'm not going to have office hours. I don't think we're going to insist that everybody have office hours. I do other things. So, I guess the question is, do we want to try at least have a sense of, as this subcommittee or this larger committee, do we want to have a feel for what's working, what isn't, what's being done, what isn't, or we just kind of maybe right now we just let 1,000 flowers bloom and we'll see what happens. That's fine. But it sounds from the charge we were given, outreach communications in particular, that we sort of are supposed to be kind of paying attention in a broad way to what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
And there are, you go to the calendar, you can by word of mouth, people learn, oh, Ryan's got a newsletter, somebody else does office hours, somebody else does this, somebody does that. But there's no, do we need to, as a, this group, do we need to sort of just put that all in one place for ourselves to get a sense of how things are going?
So,
just so we have a feel for how things are going, or do we need to say, as long as things are happening, fine, you know? Because
we want to ask people to report to this. Yeah, well,
no, 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 just, yeah.
Well, we could just have them report by email. Right. We could have a little survey right. for them to fill out. Okay, so what are your upcoming dates? What are your past dates? What, you know, what are the elements? Could you give us a sample agenda for your meeting so that we can all take a look at it? And, you know, who have you had as your guests? What's worked and what hasn't? And I think people would be glad to fill something like that.
I think it would help all
a survey.
It would probably help us, like maybe at the end of this year or next year or 3 years, to be able to leave some concrete guidelines and procedures and help for other counselors. I mean, I think that everything we do is establishing a process.
So that would that be deliberation, or would that just be procedural, you know, like just, it seems to me like it's not deliberation on any particular issue before the council or anything, right?
I don't think so. I mean, I think if this subcommittee wanted to come up with, you know, finalize an idea and come up with, say, a questionnaire, say that, I don't know, it could even just be sent simply to the chair of the committee, and then the chair would out.
Well, here we're thinking of counselors, I think. We're thinking of the 13 counselors and what they are doing in terms of outreach and communications.
Right.
Literally what they are doing, and secondly, if they want, what success or what advice or, what, you know, what's worked and what hasn't.
Yeah.
Is that like something we want to do?
Survey Monkey or a Google form or something like that. People could fill out a Google survey.
And how important is it for the council to have sort of like a broad picture of what at the moment, at some given time, say in 2 months or whatever, this is what is happening on the outreach and communications front in terms of this is how many district meetings have been held, this is how many office hours are being held, this is how many, you know, newsletters, whatever. I mean, just, you know, just a general statement of where we stand. And that would be something I would think we could provide as a service to the council if we want to take it on.
I think the Hampshire Gazette would be interested in that story. How is the new council functioning as far as, you know,
outreach and communication?
Yeah. Was it fulfilling its promise of public participation?
Right.
As we brought up before, just something to think about. If we are seeing our role as sort of gathering information,
right.
being a committee that sort of keeps an eye on, a timeline, there's so many forums have to be, by the time council have to be held in a certain, within a year's time. Like those kinds of things, should we have a timeline for some of those things? Do we want to establish that? And then do we want to just maybe check in, ask the RAC and be participation officers if they could report out either to, I'm going to guess to us. Or
well, you told us this,
but do we want to have a sense of what, broad outreach is, or do we want to just concern ourselves with town council's outreach?
Just looking at our charge, but yeah.
Yeah.
It is focused on town council, which seems appropriate. And I think at some level we should be providing some sort of overview or picture, occasionally a snapshot, of what is happening and what people think is working and what isn't. And as you said, to how successful have we been in this first 6 months or whatever at actually getting people engaged, involved, in terms of, we as a council, how well are we communicating? We as a council, how well are we doing outreach, however we define outreach? Certainly that would include district meetings, public forums, office hours. I think it also includes, but this is a whole other area, of what we do individually in terms of reaching to, I mean, I go to a lot of groups and talk to people about what we're doing. I consider that an important task, a job that I'm supposed to do, I'm particularly working with students, but I'll talk to anybody, and I'm sure others are doing the same thing. But there's no list or record of that. I mean, I keep a record of what I do, but, you know, would it be worthwhile or valuable for people to know, you know, where counselors have been going and who they've been talking to as a sort of outreach function? Or is that, you know...
I think
counselors would report. I mean, I would report. I would write down on a piece of paper or on a form or whatever. I'd say, okay, in the past month or two, these are, you know, I've talked to Interfraternity Council. I talked to Panhellenic Council. I talked to Massburg. I talked to the Mass Democrats. I talked to this neighborhood association. I talked to that neighborhood association. You know, so you list it. In part, simply to, if someone says, you know, you guys really don't, you know, reach out, you don't talk to anybody. Well, look, here's a list of, you know, 30 outreaches that happened by various counselors. What we would be the sort of repository or sort of the clearinghouse for this, so that we could at some point in 5 months, 6 months, whatever, be able to give data, be able to give actual factual data. This is how many public, you know, this is how many were held, this is how many newsletters there are, this is how many, you know, district meetings have been, this is how many office hours have been held, and, you know, just, that seems important.
I agree, and it just...
And that would be our job.
So, our charge is, one, communications and outreach, A, advise the town council on matters related to district meetings, section 2.7,
mm-hmm.
public forums, section 2.13 and 5.3, and other strategies to broaden participation, ensure regular and transparent communication, and outreach to residents. So I think being a repository of, especially this first year, what people, counselors are doing,
mm-hmm.
and what sort of their sense of what is working and what isn't working,
mm-hmm.
I think would be great. And I also think that it might be within our charge to then, maybe we could, or it would be for us to maybe make a small packet for counselors going forward that gives them some, you know, some of the guidelines that we were given participation officers, and then maybe some guidelines that we or tips that we have, you know, seen work in the past, you know, a year or 2 years.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm just thinking that having a structure is definitely helpful. I mean, we none of us have a structure to begin with. We're all finding our way.
Mm-hmm.
I just think that as we're finding structure, next counselors, just so that they be somewhat up and running or have an idea, so they're starting from scratch.
So there's best practices, which we could work on,
mm-hmm.
and then there's just data. There's two different things. Here's what's been happening, and here are some best practices for going forward.
Which we may not know until the end of our year.
Right. But
you know,
whatever.
Quite honestly, you know, there's a, you know, we're all finding things out by trial and error.
So maybe one step would be, concretely, would be for this subcommittee to consider reaching out to all the counselors by email and saying, you know, one of the things we think we should be doing is just keeping some kind of account of outreach that's been going on the council since we've been created in December. So it's asking them to do something, which I know myself, it's like, oh. But could you begin to assemble a list of some of the, you know, things? Tell us your office hours. If you had district meetings, when and where. At this point, we're just collecting data. We're not interested in the agendas. We're not interested in that. We just want to know what are things you've been doing in terms of outreach. Is that something that we should add to the list to-do list for our other counselors? Would that be useful? With the thought that eventually we would tabulate this and present it to them and say, here's a record of what you've been doing over the last, you know, 6 months, and also a record we could then share with the public and say, you know, if you have a question, here's what we've been doing.
And so what Darcy suggested, and I don't know what you think about it, is doing it maybe in poll form, which might be easier checking out boxes.
I think this is going to be, unfortunately, people really have to sit down and list. You know, I've talked to this.
Well,
I have
it in
district.
Poll form. Well, the advantage to doing it with a, you know, SurveyMonkey or
mm-hmm.
Google survey
mm-hmm.
is that the result comes out on a spreadsheet
mm-hmm.
that people can look at.
Right.
It's easier to, you know, to get, the result is easier to manage than if
so
you just
how we shape
if you just got, you know, like 13 emails.
Lists of, right, yeah. You'd have to go through and organize that. I understand. Right, 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 right.
But would there be places that you might want to go back?
Well, a task for the subcommittee then, painfully, would be, because who needs another task, but would be to construct something like this.
Yeah.
To construct a document that you feel would be provide sufficient data, useful data, and that would take a little bit of time for some of us to figure out. Yeah. I guess
I can do that. It's not that hard.
Okay, and you could give us something like that to look at, and we could, that would be great. And then we can refine it, and if we're satisfied with it, then we have something we can actually send out at when we're ready.
Yeah, we can add. I mean, we can just look at a draft and figure out what we want to add. But how about like in 2 weeks or something like
that?
We didn't bring up at the previous meeting that we wanted. I want to meet next week.
Oh.
I'm sorry. What do you mean next week? Yeah.
There's some other issues. Oh no! Next week we have it's the week after it's Patriots Day.
We are meeting next week.
Then. Yeah, and then we
can
talk about it if people have time.
Okay.
You have something next week? Okay.
No, I just feel like we gotta meet every week.
I have just the opposite feeling. But that's all right. I think your feeling is the right feeling. Mine is the wrong feeling.
Yeah.
But so, last week when we didn't meet,
so good. That's why I said Merry Christmas.
It's like snow day.
Yeah.
It's a snow day. I love it. It's terrible.
Which it's is wonderful, right. All at the same time.
Okay, so Darcy is willing to sort of, construct this SurveyMonkey thing, and we'll look at it next time, and that could be useful for us in going forward. Anything else?
Do you want me, so we were kind of talking about the other thing that I think is not, is hanging in the air and has not been resolved, is how to set up the forums, and I was going to call it here, I don't know, so whatever we're calling special meetings that are being called by finance committee.
And you feel that this is something that we should be worried about rather than send it over to Paul Ewert?
But I think there's a question out there that's been posed by the council president and also by finance committee.
We've taken care of them already today.
Is that, you know, is this in our purview, both setting them up and the bigger part is bringing residents in? I do not think, and I've talked to Paul does not think that is our job. So what I would like to do is I put a couple changes on that. All it does is just add, like, you could ask for a projector. You could ask for microphones. You could ask
just tell them that we're not doing it.
Unless somebody can convince us that somehow it really is our task.
So what I would ask then, as I would probably send something to both, I would CC them, and I would ask Paul, and I would ask, but then CC them and the CPOs that we don't feel like, these things are brought up to us, we don't feel like this is in our purview. Could you set up a how-to plan for forums and hearings?
They can just, you know, give suggestions to all the counselors about what they could put on social media or whatever. Thank you, Phyllis. I would like, before we end, I would like it if our committee could communicate with Paul about the whole neighborhood cleanup issue, because that email that we got from Paul directly asking us to scout our neighborhoods for trash really threw me, you know? I felt like maybe this is a really good idea, but it felt odd to me for us to be getting that directly from the town manager rather than from either Lynn or from, I actually think it should have come from OCA.
So here's the thing, so coming back to the the events. And outreach of the community participation officers. What I believe is being said is that community participation officers work for the town manager, and that all of their outreach, including things like this trash pickup day, is theirs. And theirs for recruiting new people for town manager appointments. They do not have anything to, they help individual counselors, the CPO helps individual counselors, and they help to bring in people for Paul's appointments, and they're helping to establish a broader community. I think what we've been told is that that's their bubble and it's not our bubble. I think that we really need that clarified. We need to really know, like, what that distinction is. So if we decide to do an event, do we do an event ourselves, OCA, for town council things, and then do we let them know? I mean, to me, that's the thing that's more confusing.
Well, I just feel like we're all reaching out to members of the community. And if the town manager wants us to participate in the district cleanup, I guess that's fine, but it seems it needs to be a more holistic process.
I agree.
He did come to our last meeting and bring it up, but there was no like agreement that we would then convey to the rest of the council what we're doing, because we're the outreach people for the council. It just feels like we were left out of that loop, and it didn't feel good when I got that, and it was like, oh, wait a minute.
So we need to really clarify what's being said and where certain purviews start and end. Because my feeling from what was said was that, and this is the whole question that I have in general, is it OCA's job to plan events and to do certain procedures as town council's outreach to the community, are we completely separate, right? So that, you know, they're doing their town manager thing, and then they can invite us. Is it being made clear? We need to make it clear. Are we tagging along on things that they do? Or are people seeing that it is OCA's responsibility to hold these kind of events and to come up with our own outreach strategies that are completely separate from them? That's what I need to clarify. Because for me, it seems like what's being said is we're completely separate. And I feel that I need the clarification of are we completely separate or not? And then we could talk about how we want to go with that. But that's a big question. I agree.
So you're sort of saying, that we need to be working together it needs to be made clear if we're just like working parallel,
yes.
Or whether
yes.
we
yes.
are helping each other
yes.
do our
yes.
different tasks.
Yes.
And it seems very clear to me that we should be doing both, you know, we should be working together and collaborating. So I think that we could express that to the town manager.
I think that's what he was looking for with this event, but it came obviously quickly, and it came, you know, I think someone came up with a good idea, or an idea that Paul's had experience with, and I think one of the CPOs had experience with, and they thought, this is a great idea, this is a way to get people involved. And then they said, and let's get the town councilors involved. So it that's how it happened. And I think, you know, that's a good thing. But there's still this confusion that we're going to have to resolve. But this event, I think, was not designed to sort of him telling us what to do. Here's this idea. This is something we're going to do. We think it's a great idea for the community. Can you help us by doing X, Y, and Z? And in my case, I'm not sure I'll get around to going through my neighborhood and making a list of trash. But maybe I will. But I've already started looking. I'm sort of making notes in my head. So But I didn't see it as an order or some kind of usurping of power. I just thought, they got this great idea, they're going to run with it, and you know, this is a way we could help. So I will try to help if I can, and I'll try to show up on the day, because I think it's a great thing. But going forward, and maybe it'll become an annual thing. But I'm not so much worried about, I don't think it was an attempt to sort of tell us what to do. It's just, you know, cooperate with us, collaborate with us, if you can. And if you can't, you can't.
We should have been looked in, though.
So, maybe this is a process question.
Yeah, we're all, it's all new.
This is the process question that we're all learning and that we need to lay down. And that's why I want to get clarification of how we're going to do that.
What the spheres are, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So that it doesn't seem weird or...
Okay.
All right. That's
good. I think, yes, we have one action item.
My survey?
If you would. And it's, that'd be great. If you can do that, it'd be great. And then we'll look at it and talk about it. And that's in 2 weeks, not next week. So that's actually 3 weeks then, because I think in the second week is Patriots Day, right? So next week we meet, but the following week is Patriots Day. So it looks like it's 3 weeks.
Unless we decide to meet that week.
Not a Patriots Day, for God's sake.
Not a Patriots Day. We have to move as a meeting.
Okay. Well, it's possible. It could happen.